What is going on, everybody? There has been a lot of hoopla about the Associated Press releasing the NFL All-Pro team. I've been getting a lot of questions about who I would have on my team, so I decided to put together my own roster here, my own list. Now, my criteria is a little different. Everyone's kind of got their own criteria for this. Mine is strictly based on what I saw this year, who is the best player at each position. I'm building a team with a base roster here. Who do I want based on how good these players truly are? Now, obviously, if a player missed too much time, he's going to be ineligible for this list because it is a 2017 list. Okay, so let's get into it here. Starting with quarterback, the AP, Associated Press, that is, took Tom Brady. I'm actually taking Carson Wentz. I don't think he missed so much time that I'm uncomfortable putting him on this list. He was the best quarterback this year, on pace for the most touchdowns on film. He was doing everything, making all the throws you want, extending plays, being a magician on third down. This one wasn't even that hard for me. Yes, Tom Brady is great, but his season, although he's probably going to win the MVP, was not very spectacular by his standards. I think there was some drop-off that's not being discussed as the rest of the league has pretty much fallen apart. Let's not forget, Carson Wentz was well on track to winning that MVP before that awful ACL injury. All right, let's move on to the running back. I have agreement here. I took Todd Gurley. When I have agreement, I'm not going to break it down too much. I think Todd Gurley was the best, most explosive running back this year, and I don't expect a whole lot of disagreement on that. All right, at receiver. We got agreement here as well for my top two receivers. So Antonio Brown, thought was the best receiver in the NFL this year. He has got to be the smoothest receiver I have ever seen. His, not just his routes being smooth, knowing where he needs to be, but he just has this magical ability to bring in the ball while keeping his feet all intact, just all in one fluid motion. It's kind of hard to explain in words, but it's almost like he's a pianist out there, and just everything is just coming together like one of those musicians who can just sit down and play without the music. And then DeAndre Hopkins as my second receiver, the same as the Associated Press, just producing without Deshaun Watson was the impressive thing. I mean, no surprise here, really. We know DeAndre Hopkins is extremely talented. And then I added a third receiver as well, because you do really see mostly three wide sets out there in the NFL. So I went with Julio Jones. The stats weren't remarkable, but man, when this guy gets the ball, no one wants to tackle him and no one wants to cover him as well. Just such a freak, but he does run great routes. Wouldn't expect a whole lot of disagreement here on this one. And then at tight end, we went between Kelce and Gronk. Their stats were almost the same when it came down to it. I had to go with Rob Gronkowski though. And that is also who the Associated Press here took. And then moving on to the offensive line, David Bakhtiari at left tackle. The Associated Press took Andrew Whitworth. Now, David Bakhtiari had the best pressure rate in the NFL of any offensive lineman. He allowed one sack this year, just 12 pressures. Just a little bit of time early in the year. But again, the rates there were higher per snap than any offensive lineman. At left guard, I took Roger Saffold. The AP went with Andrew Norwell out of Carolina. Could have gone either way here. I just like what Saffold brought to that Rams offensive line this year specifically. I know he's been there, but getting to play next to Andrew Whitworth, I think really elevated his game as well. Looked really good there. Opening running lanes for Todd Gurley. At center, I had agreement, Jason Kelce. Now he does struggle in pass protection at times, but his run blocking is just so exceptional. He's such a freak athlete. Really springs open holes, not just in the trenches, but especially once you get him out in the open field. Such an athletic offensive lineman. Then at right guard, this one wasn't even a question for me. The AP actually had David DeCastro, which I suppose is fine, but Zach Martin to me is the best guard in the NFL. I feel like he's been that since he came into the league, so this really wasn't that hard for me. And then at right tackle, I went with Lane Johnson. Agreement there from the AP. Just the best right tackle in football, and it's pretty much not even close at this point, as he really separated himself this year, getting to play the entire season. So let's move on to the defense. So we've got the D lineman here, Aaron Donald. Agreement, obviously, probably the NFL defensive player of the year. Guys, 66 hurries, leading the NFL in that category. Of all positions. That is incredible. Out of an interior lineman, he has 12 sacks. This guy, I mean, you could give Aaron Donald the MVP and I wouldn't blink. And then my second D lineman, I had Geno Atkins here. He was 50 in hurries. Now, between interior linemen, Donald, as we said, had 66. Atkins had 50. And then the next guy down had 39. Atkins did get 10 sacks. The AP took Cam Hayward. I'm not going to fight anyone too much on that. Hayward did have a great year. But personally, I think Geno Atkins is the better player. So now we got edge rushers. Von Miller, number one here. This is disagreement. The AP had Calais Campbell as their number one edge rusher. Now, I get that sacks are important, but I think that we're seeing this year the Associated Press is overhyping that specific stat. Von Miller was 61st in QB hurries, 61 total QB hurries, which is second in the NFL behind Aaron Donald. And then my second edge rusher here, Khalil Mack, had 54 hurries, which is fourth in the NFL in hurries behind Terrell Suggs. So I thought about Suggs, but Suggs actually had half the tackle numbers that Khalil Mack. And I agree that Suggs is not as big of an impact in run defense as Khalil Mack. So the AP has Cameron Jordan, Calais Campbell, and then somehow Chandler Jones gets in as a linebacker. I really don't understand what's going on there. Personally, I'm fine with Calais Campbell being on here. I think he made an incredible impact on that Jags defense. But like I said, my criteria is a little different. I would rather have Von Miller and Khalil Mack. It's not like these guys had down years either. But the AP also had Cameron Jordan and Chandler Jones on there. I would have put DeMarcus Lawrence ahead of those two just to break all that down, because I think there's people that are going to wonder about that. But again, Von Miller and Khalil Mack are my two edge rushers. Both had double-digit sacks and were second and fourth in hurries, which is what you really look for out of that edge rush. That sacks stat can often be deceiving. So moving on to linebackers here, Luke Kuechly for the Panthers and Bobby Wagner for the Seahawks. Pretty consensus here. This is what the AP had. These guys are just so dominant in both run defense and pass coverage. It is such an asset to have a linebacker who is going to be tough in the trenches, get those tough tackles, but can also drop back in a zone and act like a safety. And that's what both Kuechly and Wagner bring to the table. There are very few linebackers that can really bring that. And again, they did have Chandler Jones in this group as well. So then on to cornerback here. Cornerback number one, I have agreement here with Jalen Ramsey. And some people were wondering, why Jalen Ramsey? Why not A.J. Boye? All right, well, Jalen Ramsey was the shadow cover guy here, which is the number one thing I look for in a corner. Is a team comfortable having this guy go shadow around the best receivers on the other team? And Jalen Ramsey was that guy for the Jags. So he shadows T.Y. Hilton twice, 2 for 27 on 5 targets, 2 for 46 on 5 targets in the second matchup. That's pretty good. DeAndre Hopkins had the best game out of any receiver this year. It was just 4 catches for 80 yards on him. But we're talking about DeAndre Hopkins here, and that's not even 100 yards. Jalen Ramsey made Larry Fitzgerald look like a washed-up old man with 2 catches on 4 targets for negative 4 yards. And then in the other games he shadowed, well, he had that A.J. Green game where they both got ejected, but A.J. Green did only have 1 catch for 6 yards at that moment. And then in all the other games he shadowed, he never allowed more than 14 yards on 2 catches. So amazing season for Jalen Ramsey, and it all shows on tape. This guy's just such a freak athlete, can stay with anybody out there. And then my second cornerback, the AP had Xavier Rhodes, which is fine with me. I think Rhodes had a very solid year, but when you look at Casey Hayward, who is my pick here, it's not even comparable. So Casey Hayward was the shadow guy here. Rhodes was the shadow guy for the Vikings. But when I compared those numbers, Rhodes gave up bigger games to worse receivers than I saw from Casey Hayward, who in 9 weeks this season was a shadow corner, which is a very high number, by the way. Even these guys who have a reputation of following guys around aren't always doing it every game. So to do it 9 out of 16 games is quite a lot. Casey Hayward never allowed more than 76 yards or 4 catches. But the most impressive thing here, he had an average yards allowed per shadow game of just 24.67 yards per game. Just 1.67 receptions per game, and was good for a completion percentage of 43% when targeted. That is all incredible. So Casey Hayward getting my pick for the second cornerback here. And then I went with a nickelback position, which is unique here. The AP just wrote defensive back, and then they picked Darius Slay, which is kind of lazy. That's basically just picking a third cornerback. Well, let's talk about real football here. You're going to have your two corners, and then a lot of teams are going to have your edge rushers, two linebackers, and then a nickelback in there. Pretty basic for every team out there. So for me, the best nickelback in the NFL, and it's not even close this year at least, Tyrann Mathieu. Awesome season for the Cardinals. Didn't get talked about too much because the Cardinals weren't very good. But Mathieu was third among tackles for non-safety defensive backs. He over doubled PFF's grades for pass rushers out of defensive backs. And his coverage ability is just fine out of that nickelback position as well. So I didn't want him to go overlooked because he had a fantastic season in a starting position in the NFL. Let's not forget that nickelback is a starting position in modern football. And then at safety, Kevin Byard, guys. I'm not going to dig too deep into this. I think Byard had a great season, but interceptions at the safety position are far from what I look for when I'm looking for a great safety. I mean, he had three against the Browns. I'm going to be honest, I didn't even watch the Jags game at the end of the year where he had two more. Maybe I'll go and watch that and change my opinion of Kevin Byard. But you're going to take Earl Thomas's spot? I don't think so. I don't need to watch much more Kevin Byard film to know that he doesn't have the range that Earl Thomas has back there. Sure, he didn't have as many interceptions. Interceptions for a safety, how many times is it a sailed ball over the middle where the safety just has to stand there and catch it, or the corner does all the work and it just tips up and the safety has to run over and get it? I want to know how afraid of this player is the opposing offensive coordinator, the opposing quarterback. Earl Thomas is striking fear in opponents. I don't think Kevin Byard's there yet. And then my other safety here, Harrison Smith. I have him listed as a strong safety, but man, this guy can play free safety, strong safety. You can blitz him off the edge. You can drop him into a zone underneath. You can have him play deep zone. I mean, Harrison Smith is so versatile. No brainer here to have Harrison Smith. There is agreement here, as the Associated Press also had Harry. So that's my list. Let me know what you guys think. Like the video if you enjoyed. Cheers, everyone. We'll see you next time.